Okay. If you have a headache, just put your feet in hot water. You don't need to worry about anything else, just put your feet in hot water. It will dilate your blood vessels down low. Relieving congestion in your head. No, if you got more blood in your feet, you're going to have less in your head. If you have sinus problems, put your feet in hot water. It will relieve that stuffiness. But now, if you got a cold, influenza, okay, you want to use the full treatment. So I have prepared, I've put a blanket on a chair. On top of that, I put a sheet. So the patient sits down and I wrap the patient in a sheet. Now it's nice to have a bigger sheet and cover up the whole bucket too. When you put it on, you want it tightly around the neck. You don't want cold air going down and making the person chill. Then you wrap them in a blanket. See, the purpose is to raise their temperature. When you raise the temperature, your immune system gets stronger. Also, when you raise the temperature, you're going to start to sweat. Sweating, you're getting rid of toxins. Also, when you raise the temperature, viruses can no longer replicate. And also, it helps with pain. It relaxes. So now, her feet are in water. But you don't want it so hot, they go, oh, ow, ow.
Degrees.
So in nice and easy. But once they're in, then you take this. Then you take hot water. Now you don't just go. That'll hurt too. So you expose the feet. Put your hand down in the water. Move the water. And slowly pour. You just learned something. You don't have to ask them, is that too hot? You don't have to. First thing she did is the other foot went on top of the one foot.
って、あの、重ねて、あ、避けたので。
As soon as you see the feet start to do something。
もし足がこう動き始めたら。
Stop。
やめてください。
Yeah, until their foot gets used to it。
この足がちゃんとあの、タンパクト、慣れるまで、ちょっと待ってあげてください。
Why don't you do a little bit differently this time?
もう一回、確認します。
I'm gonna move that foot over。
足を避けて、かき混ぜながら、また熱いお湯を加えています。
And very slowly。
とてもゆっくり。
Once they get used to it,
彼女が慣れてきたら、もっともっと加えていきます。
Because your body gets resistant, and you keep getting hotter and hotter.
どんどん熱くなってもどんどん慣れていくので、どんどん加えていきます。
But it's up to the patient, not a piece of paper, not something you read in the book.
あなたのマニュアルやこの読み物を見て考えるのではなく、この患者に合わせてやってます。
Everyone is different.
みんな違うのでその人に合わせて。
I like it hot. Some people can't handle it.
けど暑いのが苦手な人もいるのでちゃんと合わせるようにします。
Once you've got it where it should be,
もういいくらいになったら、
you're looking for something to start.
何探さなければいけないところがあります。
Sweat.
汗を
吐
いているかどうか。
And what I do is I'll just be sitting there, and every once in a while I'll just touch the forehead.
時々こうやっておでこを触るようにします。
And as soon as I feel sweat,
汗をちゃんと見つけたら、
I will start cooling the head.
頭を冷やすようにします。
Now why do we sweat?
なぜ汗をかくのでしょうか。
It's the body's way of keeping you cool.
汗があなたの体を冷やそうとしているからです。
Because Does anyone know what a calorie is? A calorie is the amount of energy it takes to raise 1 gram of water 1 degree Celsius.
1 gram の水を一度上げるのに必要な熱量をカロリーと言います。
So, in order to go from 97 to 98,
97度から98度まで温度を上げるのに、
How many calories?
何カロリー必要ですか?
1カロリー。
98 to 99.
98 から99は?
Right. 99 to 100. But what happens at 100?
じゃあ100になったらどうなるの?
It changes from a liquid to a gas.
これが液体からガスに変わります。
In order to change from a liquid to a gas, it needs more energy.
気体に変わるためには、液体が気体に変わるということは、非常に多くのエネルギーを必要とします。
How much?
どれくらいでしょうか
？537 calories.
537カロリー。
The latent heat of evaporation.
これが、蒸発という現象です。
So where's it going to get all that heat from?
この537がなくなってしまうと、
Your body.
あなたの体が、
so when you sweat,
汗をかくと、
it evaporates,
蒸発が始まります。
So it turns from a liquid to a gas,
蒸発をすると、
it's taking that much extra heat out of your body.
この熱量があなたの体から失われることになってしまう。
And so you maintain your, if it's what yours is, 37 degrees all the time.
体の温度を37度にキープしたかったら、この汗を残さなければならない。
Now, when you get a fever,
熱があるときは、
you don't sweat.
汗をかきません。
Because the body's saying, we need heat here.
体が熱が必要ですと訴えているから汗をかかない。
It makes the immune white blood cells increase.
白血球を増やす。
Makes them move faster.
熱を上げることで白血球が早く動くことができるので体がそういうふうにしている。
So this is an excellent treatment for anyone who's having some type of a sickness that needs an immune system.
これは、風邪だけじゃなくて、イミュンシステム、抗体が必要な人にはとても有効な方法です。
Okay. Once you start sweating,
あなたが汗をかき始めたら、患者が汗をかき始めたら、まだなので、
Now, as she sweats, she's throwing off toxins. Let's say she's trying to quit smoking. Do this treatment. You might want to use a yellow sheet. If you use a white sheet, it'll have yellow stains. The nicotine comes right through the skin. So if it's first trying to get off of drugs, alcohol, tobacco, this is the treatment. So I'm just going to, now I've treated people with cancer with this treatment. Because the higher the temperature gets, the stronger their body is to fight the cancer. If I'm doing the full treatment, 45 minutes to an hour. But I only do it once a day. It takes a lot of body It takes a lot of the body working hard. You may not be moving, but your body's working hard. So once a day is fine.
Now for me, I sweat easily and a lot. Does that mean that I'm releasing toxins most of the time?
Every time you sweat, you release toxins.
Okay,
and that's good. Now, how much toxins? Have you ever noticed some people when they sweat, it smells so bad? That's a lot of toxins. Meat eaters smell bad. Vegetarians smell like a cooked carrot. So the cleaner your body, the less toxins you're going to have in there. But we are all toxic. Now you can just go to the onsen and get a nice sweat. That's good. Okay. Now, once she starts, put some on her head. Once she starts to sweat, you've got to replace the water that she's losing. So you give her sips of water to drink. But the water should be room or body temperature. Don't give her cold water. Never put cold water in a hot bottle.
あまり私汗かかないんですけど、そういう場合はどういうふうにしておく?
People who like this situation never get sweaty. What is the solution?
Put them in the oven.
Open the oven.
No, some people have a hard time sweating. But right, another thing you can do when you're doing the treatment, take their temperature. Her temperature, even though she's not sweating, should be going up. Now, one of the reasons why some people don't sweat is because they are chronically dehydrated. And basically, the body is going to conserve water for the most important things. So if you don't sweat much, you better start drinking more water. Then you will get back where you should be. People who are chronically dehydrated have higher temperatures. Because the body says we can't use all that water for sweat. Water is the best cough medicine. That's not the sign of dehydration. Because see, your body is 70% water. That's the way God made you. But if you have chronically not drank your water, it might drop down to 67%. And so when you drink more water, it's going to take you right back down again. So that's your problem. Small sips all day long. If I drink the whole bottle really fast, I will say, go inside, I'll go to the toilet. I try to drink 4 liters a day. I've got good water content. You want to talk about wrinkles? Drink your water. It'll keep your skin nice and soft. So what you have now, you have some very cold water. So what you do, is you keep the head cool. And believe me, it feels wonderful. But everyone's different. Some people want a lot of cold in their head. Some just a little bit. Ask the patient what they want. Now, when you're getting the cough wet, this is what people have a habit of doing. You put the cloth in the water,
この、あの、布を中に入れて、
hey, bring it out.
外に出して、
It's like they're wringing the neck of a chicken. And it's not as cold anymore. Just a quick squeeze. Plenty of cold water left inside. Feels so nice.See, you need to keep the patient comfortable. Now let's say the person just doesn't, for some reason, doesn't like sitting in chairs to do this. Or you've got somebody who's in the bed. They can't get out of the bed.
もしベッドで寝たきりな人だったりしたら、
they're laying down in the bed.
このようにベッドの上で寝かせて、
you put the basin here.
ここに洗面器を置いて、
put your feet in the water.
足をこの中で。
Now they're laying down.
ここに寝てる間、
they can sleep.
眠ることができる。
You can do all the stuff down here at the water.
あなたがこのトリートメントをやることができます。
Makes it very nice for people who are invalids. They can't get out of bed.
あのベッドから出れない人にもこれはとてもいいです。
Now, when would you not want, when would this treatment be contraindicated? You don't do it.
これがやらないときはどのようなことでしょうか。
What case would you not use this treatment? If a person is an insulin dependent diabetic,
insulin を使ってる糖尿病の患者にはやらないで
ください。Why?
なぜでしょうか?
Because when you put the feet in hot water, it's going to increase metabolism.
メタボリズム、代謝を促進するします。Okay.
So,When you metabolize in your cells, the main thing you're metabolizing is glucose. As that metabolizes inside your cells, it makes two things. Adenosine triphosphate, this is your energy.Water, right, and carbon dioxide. That's not good. Well, we breathe it out. But if you have poor circulation, it builds up in your feet.
足に蓄積されてしまう。
And it kills the cells.
細胞を殺してしまう。
I've known people who lost both feet.
2本の足をなくしてきた、なくす人もいます。
Because they got a hot treatment on diabetic feet.
糖尿病だったのにこの処方をやってしまったから。Mm-hmm.
So if they've got really bad circulation,
糖尿病だからこの循環がよろしくなかった。
Do something else. Don't do this.
これはやらないで他のことをしてください。
Okay. Any questions?
質問ありますか?
Do you change the water if you're doing it for the 45 minutes to an hour? Do you ever change
the
water?
Here's the question, right?
45分から1時間やるっていうことはお水を変えないといけないんですか?
When I do the treatment, I like a deep bucket.
これをやるときは私は深いバケツを使います。
And I can keep putting hot water in.
そうすると熱いお湯をつけ足すことがどう
か。When you have a shallow one like this,
このように浅いものだと、
you only get so much water in there.
お水のキャパシティ、容量が小さいので、
so you gotta keep taking water out, putting water in.
加えて出してっていうことをしないといけない。
Get a 20 liter bucket.
20リットルのバケットを用意した方がいいです。
Then you don't have to change it.
で、そうすると付け加えるだけなので変えるということはしなくても大丈夫です。
Any other questions?
他に質問はございますか?
タバコと けるとるのにとてもいいって言いましたけども、あの精神科の薬ちょっとたくさん飲んで、寝る時も睡眠寝る時も薬飲まないと眠れないような、そういうような子に薬抜くにその方法をやって、薬は飲まないように飲みながらする。どうした方がいいですか？
If you are taking medicine, people will comment on problems. Is it possibly good to use this method or what is it?
If you take the medicine for
what? For like mental problems, you cannot sleep, so you take medicine to go sleep and
okay.
to calm yourself.
Okay. If you did this treatment mild,
これを、そんなに強いレベルじゃなくて、レベルが弱いレベルでやると、
just say 40 degree water.
40度の温度とかにして、
it relaxes your whole body.
あなたの体を、すごいリラックスすることができます。
And that will help you sleep.
これが、眠るのを助けるはずです。
But if you're taking medications,
もしだけど薬を飲んでいるのであれば、
can you heat the body?
で、あなたの体を温めてしまうと、
it will metabolize the medication.
薬までこの代謝を良くしてしまう。
See, some medications are made so that they release at different times.
お薬によっては、ちょっとずつこの、体の中で出すようにされています。
If you heat the body like this,
けれども、温度を、急激に上げてしまうと、体温を上げてしまうと、
There's a law of chemistry called Van Hoff's law. It means chemical reactions are greatly increased at the raising of temperatures. That applies to all your medications.
そうすると薬にもそのような反応が適用されるので。
So it's best if you're going to do the treatment, make sure it's long enough time after the medication that it's not going to cause a problem with it.
もしあなたがお薬を飲んでてそういうことをするんであれば、ちゃんとお薬を飲んでしばらく時間が経っていることをちゃんと確認してからしてください。
Okay. If a person has a chest cold, pneumonia, bronchitis, this is the treatment.
これが、良い処方です。
If they got digestive problems,
もし、消化機能の、問題があれば、
This is the treatment.
これがいいものです。
If a woman's having painful menstruation, having a period,
okay. 生理痛?
This is the treatment.
これがいい方法です。
Because it's pulling congestion down into the feet.
ここで溜まっているもの、足で溜まっているものを、直すと改善することができるか。
Also, as you raise the temperature, you're increasing circulation all through the body.
温度、体温を上げることで、体全体の循環を良くすることができます。
We need better circulation.
われはもっと循環を良くすることが大事なんです。
Now, when you're ready to finish the treatment,
もし、これを終わる準備ができたら、
It's the most fun.
これが、とても楽しい時です。
Now, if a person, if you're doing this for painful menstruation, you don't finish it like I'm going to show you.
もしこの人がここの部位で、痛い生理痛を持っているならば、これが今からやる方法は参考にならないです。
But for anything else,
もう他のところは大丈夫です。
You unwrap the gift?
患者の方にはリラックスしていただいて、足をちょっと上げて、バケツの上で冷水をかけます。
You pour cold water on the feet.
Before cold water.
This closes the pores.
これで、毛穴をふっと閉めることができます。
And basically extends the length of the treatment because it's going to be heat's going to stay inside. Now, even before you began the treatment, you prepare the place where they're going to rest. They always rest for 1 hour after your treatment. But she's going to sweat for a long time after the treatment. So you put something plastic down first. And then the sheet on top of that. Lay them down, cover them with the sheet. If you don't have the plastic, you're giving the mattress a hydrotherapy treatment. Any questions?
Do you put socks on the people or just leave the feet open?
Okay, if what are you?
靴下を履くべきでしょうか? それとも何も履かないままやるべきでしょうか?
If I finish the treatment here,
このやる時には,
and I'm taking her over here,
彼女をここに, 移す時には,
put slippers on the feet.
スリッパを履かせるように。
You don't want her feet on cold surfaces.
この冷たい地面に足をそのまま直接乗せるようなことはさせません。
But once they're down there, you take them off.
もし、ここに休む場所に移ったら、もうそのスリッパを取るようにします。
Now when I do this treatment,
このやる時には、このトリートメントをするときは、
they don't have clothes on.
服は着ていません。
You might have a pair of swimming trunks or their underwear. Otherwise, everything is wet. How many have ever had a fever for a couple of days? Sometimes when you have a fever for a while, you wake up in the middle of the night and you're soaking wet.
Have
you ever done that? Why? Why does that happen? The way you get a fever is the body turns off your sweating.
体がこの温度が上がっている時に汗をかくというのをスイッチオフにします。そうすると熱がどんどん上がってきます。When
the body realizes they've won the war,
もし体がこの戦いに勝ったよって思ったら
it turns the water on.
そうすると水をこうオンにします。And
you sweat. And you got to change your clothes. We call that the fever breaking. It's a natural physiological event. Okay. Question was, when do you use hot and cold?
熱いの冷たいのをいつ使うかっていうのが重要なところです。あ、ホットエンドっていうあの治療法ってそれをじゃあどのような治療に使うかっていうことです。You know,
if you have two bases.
2つのバケツがあって。
One's got hot water.
一つはお湯を、あの、熱いお湯が入ってる。
One's got cold water.
一つは冷たい水が入ってる。
If you have arthritis pain. Arthritis. Arthritis.
関節炎。関節炎。関節炎の。I've never experienced. 関節炎。
You put your whatever hurts in the hot water.
Three minutes.
Cold, 30 seconds.
30秒冷たい水に今度つけます。
You go back and forth.
これを繰り返します。
Okay. This, when you put it in the hot water, your blood vessels dilate. Put it in cold water, they constrict. So basically, you are exercising and increasing your circulation. I had a patient who had really bad sinus problems. I had to put his face in hot water. then in the cold water. But there is a problem. He was hard holding his head under water for 3 minutes. I have a snorkel. He put his face, whole head in hot water. I'll be reading the book. I tap his head good in cold water. 30 seconds back in
hot.
He got completely well.
そうするともう完全に良くなった。His
congestion was so bad he couldn't even hear. Increases circulation. Carries away congestion. Now, were they going to actually practice the hot foot bath? We need to spend a couple of days
together.
I need a small patient.
If he's willing. お名前は何ですか？
I showed you the picture of the young boy in Africa. He had a high fever.
Now,
this treatment has three effects. The first one is to lower the body temperature. Okay. That's the treatment's about 12 minutes.
Okay.
So what we do is we have the patient raise their arms. We take the sheet. Stretch it over the upper body. You want it tight. So that everything, all the body's been touched by this cold sheet.
このシートに、この冷たいシートによってこれを、全部体が囲われている状態にします。
Now, and then you wrap just the leg nearest you.
このあなた側の足、今近くの方にあるこのミラー先生のいらっしゃる方の足をラップします。
Okay. So I've got one half of the body wrapped.
このなので上体と足、片足がラップされてます。
Then kneel with your arms.
そうすると、腕を下げます。
Then we're going to take this side of the sheet.
で、この今折りたたんだ方の布を、向こう側の布を一緒に取って、ここ側にこの持ってくると、上体をまた包みます。
And tuck it underneath.
で、下の方に詰めていきます。
See, now the arms have the sheet here and here.
なので、腕がこっちにもこっちにも全部布で囲まれている状態になる。
Now with this leg,
この足は、
I put this side of the sheet.
向こう側からまた持ってきて、くるみます。
Nice and tight.If you're doing, trying to lower the temperature, that's all you do.
12分間だけというのを覚えてください。
Forgot one thing.
一つ忘れてました。
You took the sheet and you put it in cold water.
シートはまず冷たい水で濡らすんでしたと。
Give it a quick squeeze. You squeeze a little bit.
さっきみたいにちょっとだけ水を絞って、ちゃんと水が水分が含まれているようにします。
And now he's surrounded by a cold.Wet sheet.
そうするとこのシート、冷たいシートで彼の完全に体を囲っている状態になります。
It brings the temperature down.
そうすると体の温度を下げることができます。
But after about 12 minutes,
12分間後には、
his body has warmed the sheet.
もう体がこのシートを温めてしまっているので、
This was number one. Lower the temperature.
なので体の温度を下げるのが最初の12分間の目的です。
But now you're going to number two.
ステージ2では、
If all you wanted to do was lower the temperature, you're done.
もう、もし体の体温を下げたいだけだったら、ステージ1でもおしまいです。
Unwrap them, it's over.
もう、布を取っちゃっておしまいです。
But now, number two, the temperature of the sheet is around 37.
もう第二段階ではこの布が37度、体温が温まってしまっているので、
So it's just body temperature.
じゃあもう体の体温に包まれているだけです。
And they relax.
そうすると彼らはもうリラックスした状態になります。
If you can't sleep,
もしあなたが眠れないのだったら、
If you have nervous problems,
もしもなんか worry,
problem, just if you have mental problems.
ああもし精神的な問題があったら、
This sedates them.
これが落ち着かせることができます。
I had a patient one like that one time.
一人患者がそういう方がいらっしゃって、
It took five of us to put him in this
thing. 5人の人間をかけてこうやってラップすることができます。
But once he's in this thing,
一回もこうやって囲まれてしまえば、
バンザイ。
You can't do it. もうこの繭の中に囲まれてしまって落ち着いているので眠ることができる。
That will take you up to around 22 minutes.
そうすると第2ステージがこれが22分間で。
But if that's all you want, you're done.
これで落ち着かせるという目的はこれでもうおしまい。
But it'll stay at that temperature for a long time.
この温度がずっと維持されることができる。
So if they're asleep, just leave them that way.
もし眠ってたらもうそのまんまにしてあげてください。
But if you want number three,
第三ステージが欲しければ、
You started out with a blanket over the person.
このブランケットをかぶせます。
Now the body's producing heat, trying to warm that sheet.
この体が温度を上げて、このシートの温度を上げようとします。
You're blocking the escape of the heat?
もう毛布をかぶせることで、さっきみたいに蒸発をしてエネルギーが奪われることがなく、そのままキープすることができ
る。Now their temperature's going up.
そうすると温度が38から39度まで上がることができます。
Now their immune system is getting into the action.
そうすると抗体が、とてもよろしくなります。
Now, if this was your goal, number three,
この3番目の、このイミューシステム、抗体を上げることが目的であるならば、
you can speed it up.
あなたはさ、これをこういうすることで、もっと、もっとスピードを上げることができます。
By putting the feet in hot water.
あなたの足を、この患者の足をお湯に入れることで。
And now they're going to get a good temperature going.
そうすると、より体温が上がることができます。
They're going to sweat.
彼らは汗をかきます。
Immune system getting strong.
抗体がすごい良くなります。
And what equipment did you need?
そうすると何が必要でしょうか?
You need a sheet.
このシートが、ベッドシートが必要です。
A blanket.
ブランケット。
And a base.
それから、バケツとか洗面器が必要になります。
Everyone has that.
みんな持ってることです。
And it doesn't cost anything.
そうするとお金もかからない。
And they can lay there and sleep and just keep their head cool.
頭は冷たくするようにしてください。
It's such an easy treatment.
とても簡単なことです。
Have a fever?
はい、発熱をしていれば。
Can't sleep?
眠れなかったり。
They're sick.
それから病気だったり。
All with the same equipment.
これで同じ道具を使ってこの3つのものを解決することができます。
Any questions?
質問はありますか？
とってもシーツ、水で絞ったシーツでお風呂の時ですね。その時は服はそのままもう着たままの状態ですか？
In this case, are you wearing clothes or?
No. Usually, when you don't hydro, it's no cold.
もうこの時も服は着ません。
Otherwise, they're going to get up and they've got all these wet clothes on.
洋服が濡れてしまって、この落ち着いた段階の後に起きた時にも全部洋服が濡れてしまいます。
Now, when I do hydrotherapy, I like modesty.
Modesty.
I don't like to have them completely.
完全に真っ裸にはなりたくないので、ある程度の服は
Yeah. So I always have leave either swimming trunks or their underwear.
下着だったり水着だったりっていうのは着させる着るようにしています。お利口さんだったね。
Well, usually what's happening is you're putting out toxins that are causing an irritation. How much water do you drink?
1日にどれくらいのお水飲みますか？she's not paying attention because this is hot child.
Yeah, huh?
This is, she's talking about hot child.
Okay, but, alright, so whoever it is, if you are allergic to your own sweat,
allergic to?
It's an allergy. I mean, if you're itching, it's because you've got a sensitivity.
この痒くなるってことは、とても敏感なので痒くなっている。
If you're sensitive to your own sweat,
自分の汗に敏感っていうことは、
it's probably because you are putting something out in your sweat that makes your skin sensitive.
あなたの汗に、この汗に何か毒素を出している。それに反応して痒くなってしまう。
Very few people know how much water they drink.
あまりの
自分の飲んでる水の量にどれぐらいっていうのを知ってる人がほとんどいない。
And most people are chronically dehydrated.
とても多くの人が脱水の状態になります。
My recommendation, get yourself a large container of water. This is Okinawa. Minimum of 3 liters. Every morning it's filled to the top. Before you go to bed, it's empty.And don't use it to take a shower. Now my water bottle has something here. It's got a little ring. And it will tell me how many bottles I have drank in a day.
そうするとそのリングが私が一日にどれくらいの本数飲んだのかを知らせることができます。
But I just drink a lot of water.
ただ私はもう常にお水をよく飲むようにしています。
We need to drink more.
なので私たちみんな、ほとんどの人がお水をもっと飲む必要がある。
ambient
temperature?Is there any preferable temperature, ambient temperature, or body temperature, all temperature?
Oh, yeah, whatever it becomes sitting around the house. Cold water is never best. Because as soon as you put it in your body has got to warm it back up
again.
Here's a recommendation. First thing in the morning, drink 1 liter of warm water. Go for a walk.
それから歩く。
Don't walk very far.
とっても離れた場所には行かないで。
Because you drink warm water,
温かいお湯を飲むと、
and you start walking,
それから歩くと、
You've got these things called peristaltic waves. Your colon starts to work things out.
Your what is
your colon?
Ah, 腸がこうあの何かをしようとしてて。
It starts warming. And if you walk too far,
もう遠くまで歩いてしまうと、あ、ここ遠いで。
You got to run to the benjo.
お手洗いに行かないといけない。
But it's a great laxative.
これをすることがいいことなんです。
It's a great way to get you cleaned out in the room.
そうすると体がきれいになる。
You have 5 organs of detoxification.
これ、体から毒素を抜くその5つのオーガンです。
Doing this hot foot bath.
これをするこの、ホットバスの足をすること。
Detoxifies your third kidney.
3つ目の、キッニー、腎臓を、3つ目の腎臓は2つあるから3つ目のサーキッニー、ファンクションです。サーキッニーです。
How many kidneys do you have?
Two.
Or you got three.
No, really?
This is your third kidney.
Oh! 我々は腎臓が2つなんですけれども、皮膚が3つ目の腎臓の役割を果たしていると。
When you sweat, you are detoxified.
なのでこう足をすることで3つ目の腎臓をきれいにしているんです。
When you urinate, you are detoxified.
おしっこをするっていうことは体から毒素を出していくんです。
So if you take a little bit of charcoal every day,
もし木炭チャコを少しずつ飲んでるならば、
helps detoxify your liver.
リバー、腎臓じゃなくて肝臓をきれいにしています。
Drink the warm water first thing in the morning, detoxify your colon.
温かい お水を飲むということ、朝に一番飲むということは腸をきれいにします。
Keep drinking, detoxify your kidneys.
腎臓をきれいにするのはお水をよく飲むということです。
Sweat, detoxify your third kidney.
3番目のキッニー、皮膚をきれいにするのが汗です。
And if you walk fast, you detoxify your lungs.
早く歩くと肺をきれいにすることができます。
Those are the five organs of detoxification. You need to get yourself detoxified. You need to detoxify your body. And quit putting toxins into your body. Go back to the old Okinawan diet. That's why Okinawa used to be a blue zone. The people living the longest in the world. Okinawa is no longer a blue zone. That generation has passed on. The generation coming up is not living like they should. I love Kentucky Fried Chicken. Hey, we're in Kentucky Fried Chicken paradise in Okinawa. You have 12 chicken restaurants. Now, I may love this stuff. The last time I ate Kentucky Fried Chicken,
April 1984.
Just because I like it doesn't mean I'm going to eat it. We need to take care of this body. It's that's the whole talk. Any questions?
Now, if we want to start drinking the charcoal, but we don't have the means to make it, is there a store here that we can buy right away?
Is
there?
You can buy from somebody, and somebody in church member family just brought from purchased from somebody from North and brought that, so she can share today.
The organization I work with sells charcoal.
If you want to order, you can talk to her, and in the future too, to get a regular supply. Please talk to them.
If you go to Eastern Europe, every pharmacy has
it.
The tablets come in paper blister packs. These things where you push the pill out. If you go to India or Africa, that's what they use to cook the food. So it just, and sometimes it's hard to find. Do your best.
We found comfrey root powder on Amazon. Is that what we can buy?
Yes, comfrey root powder is fine. Okay. Leaf or root, either one.
Leaf or root, okay.
For example,
In the States, where is a good resource to purchase?
UT Pines Institute.
UT Pines Institute is involved. UT Pines Institute is the organization of UT Pines.
Yeah. Just go on the internet.
Internet de dónde está.
Some places sell for big prices, some for little prices.
ただプライスあの価格がそのお店によっては全然違うかもしれません。
You can buy a 25 kilo bag for $50.
25キロのスパンを50ドル、5000円とかで買うことができます。
And then they put it in small bottles and sell them for $10 a bottle.
それから小分けしてもっと高いお金で売るというあのビジネスもあります。
Yeah. I know a lot of people who sell charcoal as a living.
木炭をあの経験としてあの立てている人もそうです。
あのチャコールをあの日常から取っていることは大丈夫ですか、健康な人が。
ああ、for the healthy people taking up charcoal every day.
Doesn't bother you?
あの木炭をこう取ることで害があることはありません。
Two studies done in 1947.1947年に2つ論文がされた。
もしこの鉄分のサプリメントを子供が取ろうあのお母さんが取
って全
部飲んでしまったら、
チャーコールはチ
ャーコール、ああ、木炭のピルをお母さんから取って子供が飲んでしまったら何も起こりません。
Because iron is what the body needs.
アイアンをチャーコール、アイアン。
Mama takes iron pills for anemia.
Yes.あの貧血のためにあのお母さんが飲んでいる鉄分を子供が取ってしまってもそれは害はありません。
Okay. Charcoal doesn't take it up.
炭素、木炭がそれを取ってしまうこと、鉄分を取ってしまうこともない。
So it won't bother you.
なので木炭が害を与えること
は。But now, if you're getting ready to have a physical examination,
もしあなたが健康診断に行こうとしているならば、
and sometimes they take a stool sample.
あと便も取ろうとしてたら
They will be shocked.
ちょっとショックを受けるかもしれない。
Because it's black.
便がもう黒くなってしまうので。
So stay off the charcoal before your stool test.
もし便の検査があるときには木炭は控えてください。
We had a hand over here. Yeah.
When you are drinking charcoal, is it preferable time or not preferable time to take?
We never drink with meals. Other than that, anytime you want.
If you are taking medicine.
Ah, okay. If you take a medicine, medicine's a poison.
お薬は毒素です。
That's why they have side effects.
だから副作用っていうものはあります。
So you don't take the medicine with the charcoal.
なので、茶香とめあのお薬を一緒に取ることはしないでください。
Well, many times, sometimes it might be best if you do.
もしその毒素をあのアボイあのプレハロとしてもなら薬と飲むのはいいことかもしれませんが。
But take the charcoal sometime away from your medication so it's taken up into your body.
お薬とあの木炭の時間を離してください。そうじゃない、そうするとお薬がちゃんと体の中で効く時間を与えます。
前にあの主人にあの勧めてチャコル飲ませたんですね。特に病気ではないんですけど、体にいいんだと思って。そしたら、なんか、便秘したからもう次から嫌だって言うんですけど、そういうことありませんか？
Her husband is completely healthy, but she had charcoal is good for you, so she recommended a charcoal supplement to husband, and he has the problem with constipation. Well, so he's stopped.
You see, the reason charcoal takes up water.
木炭がお水を水分を取ってしまいます。
And it can cause constipation.
そうすると便秘になってしまう。
If you're not drinking enough water.
もしあなたがちゃんとお水を飲んでなければそういう問題が起こる。
So drink plenty of water.
もっとお水を飲んでください
。But you don't need to take chocolate every day.
もちろん毎日取る必要はありません。
It's not a prophylactic. It's something used to treat a problem.
木炭っていうのは何か問題がある時の対処法としてのものなので、別に毎日飲むということはしなくても。
Maybe once a week, once a month, just to get a detox. That's fine.
一週間に一回、月に一回だとかそういうので、体の中から毒素を出すという目的では使っています。
あの竹炭をね、16年ぐらい持ってるんですけど。
竹炭？Is there any expiration date for the bamboo chapel?
Yes.
ありますけど、有効期限があります。
The day after the second coming of Jesus.
She has old ones, so she's bothering
me. As long as it's been in a sealed container.
もしこれがちゃんとあの密封されていれば、ちゃんと使うことができます。
It's
open.
If it's open, it probably already. It's taking up toxins.
毒素を空気から取ってしまっているので。
There are two main types of pure carbon.
あの2つのタイプの炭素があります。
I'm looking for the second type.
2つ目を探しています。
First type is charcoal.
1つはあの木炭です。
The second type is diamonds.
ああ、2つ目はダイヤモンドです。
Now, when do diamonds expire?
ダイヤモンドは有効期限ありますか
Well, the day after coming, the second coming of Jesus.
ここあのイエス様が帰ってくる。
As long as you protect the charcoal, it's going to stay just carbon.
木炭をちゃんと中の密封した中にやればもうそれがあの綺麗な状態で保管されるので。
But here's what you can do.
これがあなたができること。
Spread your charcoal out on a cookie sheet.
クッキングシートの上に木炭を広げます。
Put it in the oven.
オーブンの中に。
At about 200 degrees.
200 degree Fahrenheit. Oh, Celsius 200. Ah, 200度の200あの温度まで上げる。That's what he's trying to do. That's how you regenerate.
That's what you get. Yeah, that's how you regenerate.
Oh, あの200度にあの熱することで綺麗にすることができ
る。But be careful.
気をつけてください。
At 200, it's going to ignite.
200度になると火が出てくる。
So don't leave it in there until smoke starts billowing out of the thing.
なので煙が出てきたりするようなことがないんですよ。
Then you take it out and put it in the glass jar.
で、そうやってやった後にあのガラスのコンテナの中に入れるようにしてください。で、ちゃんと密封する。
Then you don't have to do that again.
もうこうすればあのもう一回やる必要はありません。もう
Yes.
And the fourth is coconut shell.
That's great charcoal. Coconut shell, good charcoal.
Okay, because that is we have in the book.
Yes. Yes.
Now, second question, would that affect the urine? Because it does affect the stool.
No. Your urine's already liquid. Your stool is becoming a solid. And it makes it even too solid. Yeah, you don't want to do that.
木炭を取ることで、便にそうやってあの硬くなって便秘になるっていう問題はあるけれども、尿の方には問題はありません。
Okay.
And you did mention earlier it was okay to take. You said take a little charcoal every day to detox one of parts of our body.
Well,
so I just wanted to.
No, I'm not saying to take it every day.
木炭を毎日取るということは言ってません。
But it will help your liver.
あなたの肝臓を助けることができます。
One of the main purposes of your liver is detoxification.
肝臓自体は、あなたの体をきれいにしようとしているものです。
So if you're taking charcoal, it takes some of the pressure off of your liver.
なので木炭を取ることで木炭がきれいに体をきれいにしているので肝臓の役割が少し軽減されることができます。
And some people's livers just work too hard anyway.
あの人によっては肝臓をすっごい働かせている人もいます。
Okay. Any other questions?
Yeah.
moderate diabetic people is okay. Diabetic people, if they have the moderate, the just like problems, if they have the diabetes, is that okay to have the foot pump?
No. Oh, you moderate.
Yeah.
Just don't make it too hot. It's usually we say insulin dependent diabetics. Okay. When you have diabetes, you start to lose your feeling. So when you add the hot water,
person
just sitting there, and pretty soon their toenails pop off. Any other questions?
Is there any other kind of people that cannot be using that food?
If they have Berger's disease, smoking disease. If there's a disease that when a person smokes, they lose circulation. There is a disease called Berger's disease. No, that's not a disease. Well, that's a disease.
It's just a type of disease.
If they have really bad atherosclerosis, they got plugged arteries. If their circulation is bad because their arteries are full of plaques. Right, that's what we're saying.
Okay,
that's the only big ones.
Thyroid?
There's a whole program for the thyroid. Part of it is putting charcoal pulses around the thyroid. Yes. But there's a whole program for it. Taking cold showers, getting lots of sunshine and exercise. Now, I know everywhere there's a nuclear reactor, there's thyroid problems. And they are on the increase in Japan. Fukushima Daiichi. How long will that be a problem? Until Jesus comes. He's the solution to all the problems. Wrinkles, nuclear reactors, thyroid.
はい、ありがとうございました。皆様まだ